Hello, everybody. I have Dave joining me today, and we are going to be talking about how data plays into the larger topic of digital transformation. But before we dive into the questions that I have for you, would you mind doing an introduction, Dave?
Sure. So I'm Dave DuVarney. I'm a principal with BakerTilly. My career, I've been working in data and analytics for about the past 20 years. I've worked for some larger consulting agencies. I worked as an independent for a while, started my own company, and then joined BakerTilly with my entire group in April of 2020. So I've spent a lot of times working with organizations, kind of getting their hands around data, helping them move forward and get value out of it.
Wonderful. Thank you. And thanks for joining me today. So, to get us started, I guess my first question for you is just let's start at the beginning. How does data drive digital transformation and help your customers on that journey?
Yeah, I mean, I think data is very much a core element of digital transformation. So when we look at it, we kind of see it across from a business perspective, four different areas. So we look at growth, we look at experience, we look at culture, and we look at operations. From a growth perspective, you're really talking about how does data enable the products and services that you might offer? And you can kind of see that in two ways. You can look at it as one, just a simple evaluation of are those products performing and how do they work? But from a more transformative perspective is how are we leveraging technology and data within our products? So if we look at kind of smart products and IoT and all those things that are happening there, that's a really good example of where data is driving what happens with those products. So that's kind of in the growth area. When we talk about the experience area, we're talking about that customer experience. How are we engaging with those customers? And again, data drives all of that. You know, how long are they staying on our website? What are the pages that they hit the most? Where are the places that they get bogged down? All of that is driven off of good collection of data. When we talk about culture, we're talking about how it affects our people. And that, for me, that really drives into what is the alignment of the organization's vision into how we empower individuals. So are we giving them the information they need to perform their functions? Are we incentivizing them in the right way, which I think is a really big area. You know, what are the key things we can put in front of them from a metric standpoint to help drive performance and help to drive their own success? And then the last one, and probably the easiest to get our hands around, is just operations. What makes us an effective organization? Where is our focus? What should we be measuring and what shouldn't we be measuring to actually operate our business in an effective manner? So those are kind of the four areas that we look at. And I think data is foundational to anything that you're going to want to do across those areas.
I think that culture one is really interesting to me because typically when we think about data, we think about growth, we think about operations, but it affects everything that we're doing with the way that we work today, and using that data to make decisions about how you motivate your team, how you keep them retained, how you, that's a very interesting topic, and I think it's something that you can't ignore when you're going through a transformation either.
No, and it's a trick, and it's an interesting area because you get into what are the things that I want to put in front of individuals to motivate them to do better, right? And that in and of itself can take a lot of kind of thought because data sometimes on the flip side, you can incentivize the wrong behaviors. So you have to be very judicious about how you actually look at the data, what are you going to measure, and then what are the expected outcomes you think you're going to get by measuring it.
Wonderful. So, as you start to work with customers and kind of go down identifying these four areas and how data can drive that transformation, what are some of the common challenges that you see your customers running into or ways that you're helping them kind of start this data journey?
Yeah, I mean, generally, a lot of times that journey starts with kind of base assessment pieces of, okay, you know, across those four, what are we trying to solve for? And not just what are we trying to solve for in the sense of, hey, we really want to grow our business or we really need to improve our operations, but let's talk about what data do you have? How easy is it to get it? What's the value of actually obtaining it? All these pieces. I think one of the things that we've probably seen in the last 5 years is that technology makes the collection of data really, really easy, right? We can collect mounds and mounds and mounds and mounds of data. The problem is we still have to distill that information into something meaningful and useful for the end user. And kind of goes back to that piece of culture and people. If you don't have the right motivators, it doesn't matter how much data you throw in front of somebody. You need to focus that data into that right piece that kind of moves the person or a growth strategy forward. So we always start with that assessment piece to kind of identify what are the key drivers. Let's get our scope to a reasonable level that we can achieve. The challenge that we see probably 90%+ of organizations is that the data is not clean. It's almost never clean. And we have to get over that hurdle first, because if you don't have a quality set of data, it doesn't matter what you do to it. It doesn't mean you can't do anything, but it very much limits the scope of what you can do if that data is both not clean, integrated, high quality information to kind of drive those decisions. So we usually have to start there first, and that'll involve things like master data management and data governance to really say, okay, how many times I go into an organization and we say, you know, what do you want to measure? Sales. And you talk to people and there's five different ways that they talk about sales, right? And what does that actually mean? So we have to get down to those definitions and communicate well, and then we can pull it forward.
Well, and even I think about some of the data that I interact with, and you go into a CRM system and there's three records of the same company named slightly different things. So they didn't show up when somebody went in to go do a search. And when you start trying to make decisions off of that data, to your point, it can get messy very, very quickly. Would you mind talking a little bit about what you mentioned data governance and master data control, but can you talk a little bit more about kind of the most effective way to navigate some of those challenges and kind of start making progress on that data decision journey?
Yeah, I really think it comes down to prioritization. So you can't go and tackle everything all at once, and you have to focus on what are those core data elements that are going to drive both the highest business value and they're the easiest to get. For a lot of organizations, I mean, I tease about sales, but in reality, you're almost majority of the time, the first thing you're going to measure is how much stuff do I sell, right? Mm-hmm. And that seems fairly straightforward, except you need to consider all the variables around how you want to look at it. Have you classified your customers correctly? Do you have duplicate customers? All of those kind of core elements. So the other way we'll sometimes describe it is we'll look at a maturity model. And there's, of course, I have to remember off the top of my head the four elements of the maturity model. But when we look at a maturity model, you've got descriptive analytics, and then I'm gonna miss the rest, but prescriptive and all the way through. But the four areas of maturity, I mean, at a high level, you're looking at your data and saying, what can I see in the past versus what can I predict in the future, right? And when we look in the past, we have to have that solid past built out. So again, it's going to come back to an org needs to start their focus on what are those key things they need to measure about the business. Then they're going to take a second step and say, now what are the key drivers that impact that? So it's kind of a phased approach to how you move through those elements.
Well, and the prioritization thing, I think, is a trend that I'm seeing with almost every single one of these conversations, and really being strategy focused, so to speak, and using some thought on the front end, whether it's thinking about your specific process or prioritizing what data is going to be the most impactful, and really being thoughtful about the journey rather than saying like, ooh, wonderful, shiny technology, let's go after it. And that seems to be the advice that we're getting from kind of everybody across the board with these interviews. So that certainly matches up with what I've heard from other folks in the digital transformation world as well. Thank you so much for joining me. And anybody that is interested in learning a little bit more about the digital team at BakerTilly, make sure to go check out Dave's LinkedIn and their website. And I'm sure he'd be more than happy to help direct you in the right direction if you've got any questions. So have a wonderful day, everybody.
All right. Thank you.